everyone. I don't know my name. And today we are going to be exploring Game Maker Studio and creating an RPG in Game Maker language because drag and drop is doo-doo. Okay, so we're just gonna name it Azabagada de Cabra. Boom, here we go. So let's start by creating a sprite because you need sprites. Just do this for convenience, middle center, since blah, 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 it's just good to do it. So we want good naming, so SPR for sprite, we're gonna call it player. So we're gonna just draw it. Boom, I was trying to do something funny, I really don't give a Please just save so you don't go whining and saying, oh, I lost all my work. Okay, so now we're going to just create an object for the sprite and just, you know, press on the sprite, select sprite, press on the sprite. We're gonna name it OBJ player. Okay, good. Good job, everyone. Now it's time to start coding. Okay, so just add event, create event, boom. Okay, so this is where we're gonna start typing our little variables and stuff. You know, the start thing. I don't know what to call it. Okay, so we'll just type in walk speed. So this is how fast the player is going to walk. So I think we should just set it to 3.5. Ah, 3.5. You could choose how fast he walks. I just find it good like this. Okay, next line, we're gonna type in collision speed. And we're gonna make that equal. You could call it whatever you want. It's just good to name it right. Okay, so we're gonna make it equal walk speed plus 2. And just put these there. You don't really need them, but it's best to just put them there. Okay, so open up rooms, and you find room 0. Double click on it, and it will open this thing. So just drag your player here. Make it as big or small as you want. Right now, if you just play the game, you will just find this, and nothing will work, and you're a failure because you haven't done anything else. It's not that easy. Okay, before we continue, let's create a new sprite, and we're gonna call it, I don't know, collision. We're gonna call it collision, sprite collision. Yeah, that's a way to name it. You could also name it here, but it doesn't matter. So, we're gonna edit it, and best keep it simple. Trust me, just keep it simple, and listen to me, keep it simple. It really has to just be this, okay? So, right click, edit layer properties, and we want to turn down the opacity to like there, 43. Okay, done. So we have our sprite, it's called collision. So now we need to create an object called object collision. Okay, and we make the sprite, sprite collision. Okay, now just tick the solid box, and practically now, when you just double click on player, and you press on add, and press on collision, and you press on this, if you walk into object collision, it will collide, but we haven't even done the thing that makes it walk. Okay, so in the object player, we're gonna just add a step event and step. I'm just gonna paste this down, and I'm gonna explain what it does. So, what is the... So this checks if you're pressing a key. So this is keyboard check, virtual keyboard right, so the right arrow. You could also just erase it and put it in quotation marks, as in like W. But then you're gonna need to do some more complicated things that I don't wanna do. So I'm just gonna leave it like this with the arrow keys. So now we're going to do a double and, or you could just type in the word and. It really doesn't matter. So just nice like that. It makes you feel like a coder.
If the basis phrase is touching collision speed on the x or y axis, then x plus equals walk speed. So x plus equals, this is like the opposite of this.
Okay, okay. I admit I don't know what
this is. Same thing over here. You actually don't need it.
Editing Joe here. This code could also be written as this. In the video, I wrote a abbreviation, which means the exact same thing. And in the video, I forgot to explain how. So, over here, if place free x... Okay, fine, I don't know what this is. But if it's not touching something, then change the x-coordinate by how much walk speed. So it will move x by 3.5 because over here walk speed is 3.5, so it will move the character 3.5.
You don't actually need this, but it's just for nice, you know, smooth controls. So if we drag in our object collision and we turn off the grid, we now could just resize it, do anything with it, and as a cadabra or whatever, as you can see, it bumps into it. And usually if you didn't add in that extra code, it will just jam when you do this, but it's smooth and nice and doesn't stick. So yeah, nice smooth controls. Okay, but if you don't want this red bad thing to be here and you want to decorate, create another sprite. You can do whatever you want, make it fancy how much you want, go wild. Okay, I'm not an artist, but this is a fence, okay? Don't question me. Okay, so now we're gonna just create an object for the fence. So we're gonna do OBJ fence, and we're going to make the sprite fence. You just leave it there, okay? It's just for decorations. Don't know how you rotate things. Sucks. Okay, spoiler alert, it is Alt, so we're gonna just press on Alt and this thing comes up, and we could just put that there, and then we could copy it, paste it, and then we rotate it perfectly, and then we could just copy it. We're gonna drag in the collision, and we're going to put it there, how much we need. You don't even need the grid for this, you could do it whatever how you want. And there you go, it doesn't even have to be exact. Look, if I do it half, it's actually gonna be good. So if I just put it like... Now this one is over here. Okay, so now look what happens when you try to play the game. I just made the character a bit smaller, but nothing really. Okay, so if you can see the character, it hits against the collision. And as you can see here, it still hits against collision. It doesn't need to be with the fence. And as you can see here, since I put the collision back, it doesn't collide with it. Yes, and the thing is, if your player is over here on top of everything because you added it first, it's gonna see, the fence has to be lower than the character. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna get out of it, we're gonna make this a bit bigger for no reason, we're gonna get the player, we're gonna drag it to the bottom. So now the player will be on top of everything because it's at the bottom of everything.
So now we run it. Alakadabra, blah, 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 boom. And if this red thing, you don't like it. And by the way, if you tap two arrows at the same time in opposite directions, it does nothing. Kind of moves, but whatever. And if you don't like the red, usually you turn it off. You just go here and press on this, which makes it invisible. But I'd leave it on just for, you know, developing the game and like testing out. As you can see, it works now and it's invisible, and it also works from behind, by the way. And there you go. That's the first tutorial in the series, hopefully, of how to make an RPG in Game Maker. Alakadabra, bye bye, and roll my outro.